All right, I have something special today. Got some records that they look like they've been recorded by a home recording machine. And in case you didn't know, back years ago, like in the early 50s and 1940s, or maybe even earlier, there was a home recording machine called a Recordio that recorded on records. It looks like I found some today because of the way they're made. This one here, you notice the three holes. What that would do is the machine would clamp down on at least one of these holes, if not all of them. I'm not way too familiar how those worked, but what they would do is it would clamp down, and then there was a needle that was fed in the recording. What to record, and it would stamp it on the disc, more or less. So what was happening is it was much like a tape recorder. This one, I don't know what speed it is, so I'm going to take a guess at 78. I don't even know what material is on these either. You'll notice there's no lead out there, so it won't turn off by itself or anything like that. It sounded like that one just had piano music on it. I'm going to flip the other side and see what it has. I think that one just so happened to run over close enough the player turned off. Or maybe it does have a laid out grivet. That's what it looks like. This side don't. This one here, I can definitely tell you that it was recorded on August 27th. 1941, whatever material is on here, but you'll have to excuse my cursive reading because it's not the best, so I'm going to let you all interpret that. So we're going to play the side with the date on it first, and just kick the camera tripod. Oh, and before I notice, I'm going to tell you what I notice is what I'm going to say is, I don't know if you can see this rim here. That's I believe it's like a shellac or a lacquer. I don't know for sure, so don't quote me on that. But it's on a metal blank, and these type of records were known for peeling, and peeling or flaking or whatever, and this one has survived in very, very good shape, and we'll see how it plays now. Even though it says 33 and a third RPM on the record label, I'm sort of doubting that because it looks like a 78 to me. So we'll see. Side that didn't have a date on it. I just don't want to drop these records like I normally would with the changer, because it might damage them. I've heard of that happening. And this is the only type of 78 player that I have. And unfortunately, there's no way to hook up an MP3 player to this. I wish I could, because I'd like to do 45s too, and not have to get up and change the 45 every 2 or 3 minutes. You know what I mean? For something a little more, maybe of a historical reference or something like that, if you know what I mean. But I'll settle for the piano play, and hopefully maybe I'll get some more of these records in the future. And for right now, I'm going to say thanks for watching, and more to come later, and God bless.